I'd like us to focus on national matters for just a moment. Now, James, I'll start with you. There are many referenda that are being proposed to the Kenyan public. There's the Pesa Mashinani, there's the Okoa Kenya initiative, Punda Amechoka, we're hearing that from Moses Kuria. What are your thoughts in terms of the referendum and where we are going to at this point? We're just about to go into an election in 2017.
Well, first of all, it must be recognized as the right of every Kenyan to ask for an amendment of the constitution if they feel that there are certain areas that are not serving the members of the public well. The other thing that I think that needs to be taken cognizance of is the fact that there also have been issues raised, especially by the Supreme Court, for example, about the decisions of the time for making the decision of presidential elections. 14 days, they have said that particular time is not good enough for them to write judgments, come up with a reasoned judgment, and I think I understand where they're coming from. But having said that, at the end of the day, one of the things that we must look at is that everything must be done within the public interest. If it is within the public interest at this particular time to have a referendum for example, anchor and give devolution power, I think that is something that is welcome, and it is not something that we should shy away from, because it is provided in the constitution that anybody who wants to have a change of the constitution be given time to do so.
Okay.
But finally, what I wanted to say also is this, that this is a new constitution. When you have a new constitution such as the one that we have, it will be tested by court rulings, it will be tested by trying to have some areas being corrected to suit the national interest. Mm-hmm. And the constitution finally is a living document. It is a document that has to take development of times and also bring in issues, the progressive issues that come every day.
Okay.
Can I just say that each of these processes proposing amendments to the constitution by referenda are an indication that our democracy is healthy and that the constitution is functioning. I think it is the imperative of the Law Society of Kenya to ensure that whatever these processes are undertaken in circumstances that honor the rule of law and uphold the constitution. I don't think that it is the place of the Law Society to determine what the public interest is. That is what politicians
all right,
will
but
do.
Would you be willing to discuss some of the issues that are there, including reducing the number of counties, including more money to the counties, in fact even reducing the representation of women as has been put there? Let me just give you an example, because it seems, gentlemen, you are going to be a little noncommittal on this issue tonight. The Attorney General Githu Muigai says no referendum is needed and is talking rather more about minimum reforms package than overhauling the system and a big shake-up of the constitution. Do you have any specific thoughts to that whatsoever? Because I've just gotten some general statements from you, Isaac. Let me come to Alan and then we'll come to you, James.
Well,
yes.
Don't make general statements. I've not even had my piece yet.
All right.
No, it's
get,
very
get in there, please.
I had a very interesting conversation with a senior counsel who came up with, he was involved in the constitution making process. Mm-hmm. And he said, we seem to be approaching the issue of amending the constitution the wrong way. Yes, there's a need to amend the constitution. But then if you're going to go and do it in piecemeal, today, for example, we have this group saying we want to amend it. There's another group that wants to amend it and do something else. Why can't we have a constitutional committee to address all the pertinent issues? For example, personally, I feel that part of the aspect dealing with the judiciary has to be amended. We made a mistake in having specialized courts instead of having one high court with divisions. So what has happened? Cases have stagnated. Who are suffering? The lawyers and the citizens. So I think the better thing to do is identify all the issues that need to be addressed once and for all. So when we go to a referendum, we'll not have a constitutional amendment every 3, 4, 5 years. It's too expensive. So get together, find out from a constitutional committee what needs to be addressed. Once that is ready, then we can give it to the public.
All right.
Yeah, in fact, first of all, I want to address something that my learned friend has said, mm-hmm. that it is not in the place of the Law Society to decide what public interest is. One of the ways the Law Society of Kenya helps the members of the public by coming up with public interest litigation. In fact, when I was at the East African Law Society, one of the things that we did very successfully was public interest litigation. Because you see, as a public interest litigator, you must understand the science and the politics of public interest litigation and how it improves the welfare of the members of the public. But the other thing which I wanted to point out also, following up what my brother Alan has said, is that even in the CIC report which they submitted before their term came to an end, mm-hmm. they appointed very many areas that needs to be addressed. Mm-hmm. They have addressed issues that they think that in the time when they were there for the last 5 years, that Kenyans would need to look at so that constitution can be addressed. You see, this constitution was made for Kenyans. It is by the people of Kenya. In fact, it starts by saying, we the people of Kenya.
Okay, so what are your specific issues, James?
My specific, what I wanted to say is this. Yeah. If the people of Kenya at one particular point feel that now it is time for them to amend the constitution, nobody should stop them.
Agreed. But like you both say, and I think this is interesting in terms of just giving a view, because you're saying, Isaac, that you know it is not in the place of the Law Society of Kenya, you know, to speak on matters.
I think there needs to be There needs to be a proper understanding of the place of the Law Society of Kenya as an institution. For example, I've heard my brother say that when it comes to determining what position one political party or not takes, it is imperative that members should not be part of political parties. The Law Society of Kenya is not supposed to be a referee as to disputes between political parties. There is an institution for that. You know, in the 90s or before, when the Law Society of Kenya was forced to take a specific position in the role of opening up democratic space, and it executed that mandate very well. Once that space had been opened up and institutions began to form, then the Law Society must remain true to what its mandate specifically is.
Okay, let's speak about that mandate, Isaac.
And not stray into areas which...
Let's speak about that, Isaac, because as we put in our Super Bowl presentation earlier, the mandate of the LSK is to advise and assist members of the legal profession, the government and the larger public in all matters relating to the administration of justice in Kenya.
Yes.
So my specific question to you is, what would your advice be in the matter of referenda that are facing Kenyans today?
My advice would be that whichever route that is undertaken in accordance with the Constitution must be true to the provisions of the Constitution. We cannot begin to police the methods that any of the players take as long as they are in conformity with the Constitution and the rule of law. That is how we remain neutral and are able to advise the public, the government, and members of the profession.
Yes,
I am a bit surprised with what my learned brother is saying. That in fact, if you look at one of the objectives of the Law Society, is about the Constitution, mm-hmm. protection of the Constitution. So when he begins to say it is not in the Law Society ambit to try to police, we are not policing. We are simply saying that this Constitution, which was passed by the people of Kenya, any amendment that is done must follow the spirit about which the people of Kenya passed it. If the issue is about the gender equality, mm-hmm. and the members and the Kenyan society say they want the gender equality, that must not be curtailed.
Okay, all right. I'd like to speak about another issue.
May I add something on that?
Yes, very quickly. We're running out of time.
Just to point out one very important thing, that we as a Law Society constituted a specialized committee to look into the issue of promoting the Constitution. That committee is in place. Now the CIC as role has come to an end, and it will advise the membership of what needs to be done.
Okay, I'd like
Let to... Let me just add, this is very important.
All right.
That committee came into existence in November of... early November of 2015. The committee remained absolutely silent as the Judicial Service Commission Act was amended in Parliament by a reading that occurred in November of 2015. And you must remember also that the Hansard record is made available to the public upon its publication on the website of the National Assembly. So people would have known. Now, that isn't to say that blame must fall squarely on the Law Society leadership or the committee.
Okay.
All lawyers should have noticed it and didn't.
No, let me finish my point.
Let me just finish my point, James. Let me finish my point.
Because you see, as a member of the Law Society who wants to become a leader, I think it is absolutely wrong for you to... You know, this committee is led by senior members of the society. They were just elected in November. They have had their two sittings. Now, my learned friend is trying to say that this committee is moribund, is not even playing. It is good to be honest,
okay,
and be respectful to your colleagues in the profession.